Hi, welcome to Lori Krein's Art Studio. I'm glad you could join us today. We're very excited to have a special guest on our show, Cheryl McKinney. Welcome.
Thank you very much.
I'm really glad that you could join us today. Cheryl has been working on these art journals for quite a long time, and she came to one of my classes in my studio and to do collage, and she brought one of her art journals with her one day to show me. And I was so blown away by it that I just had to invite her on the show to share it with everybody else and show everybody what she did. And it's really an incredible process. So you work at a chiropractor's office by day?
Yes.
And by night you do this.
That's right.
Part of the time. So that's really excellent. And the best part about these journals when I saw them was that they are very eco-friendly because they're made from... You use magazines?
I use magazines that they're outdated magazines that we have in our office or ones that I get at home. And I also use books that I get from the thrift store or yard sales or the dollar store. And I just use the pages of the books to glue on the collage journaling pages into the story, into
wow.
the book.
Wow. So you don't have to buy anything new except for maybe a glue stick here and there?
Just the glue sticks. That's all
wow.
all that I ever have to buy.
That's fantastic. And that fits right in with the theme of this show. We try to share eco-friendly art with people. So and usually I do an eco-friendly art tip of the day, but since this is just so fabulous of a project and we have so many books to share, I'm just going to cut right to the chase. But I do want to remind our viewers that if you wanted more information about what we're going to do on the show today, or if you want to send me an email or have ideas for the show, please send me an email. My website is LoriKreinStudios.com, and you can reach me through that. And if you have an interesting project or idea that you've done, maybe we'll have you on the show. So keep in touch that way. And also, I have my scheduled classes through Meetup.com. Anyway, so... All right, first of all, we've got a lot of things to cover today. I want you to know if you could just kind of go one by one and just tell me if there's a theme or anything for each of the books. So I'm just going to hold them up and see if Jason can get a close-up of the cover at least. And what was this one?
That is my Facebook one, and I actually started doing that journal at about the same time I joined Facebook on my computer. And I thought, oh, faces, I love faces, faces of animals, people, toys, anything that has a face I'm really intrigued by. So I thought, I'll make an art journal with faces. So I call that my Facebook. And on the first page here, I've just kind of introduced the journal as to welcome to my Facebook page and just... invite people to join me in just looking at the faces through the journal.
All right. Oh, I can't wait to... I haven't seen this one yet, so I'm really excited. I haven't seen... Actually, I've only seen one of these, so I'm really... I can't wait to dig into these. But before we get into the details of each one, I want to just let people know the different themes or variety that you've done. So this one is dolls?
This one's dolls, and this one is actually the first one that I had done. And it's dolls also because I have a doll collection, and... my dolls were overtaking my house, so I thought, I can't buy every one that I like and see. So I thought, I subscribed to Doll Reader magazine, so I just started cutting pictures out. And I thought, I'll just save the pictures. That's good enough for me. I can look at what I like. And then what I started doing also was incorporating quotes and my own sketching and artwork into the journal pages. And
wow.
what is fun for me is to think outside the box. This first journal is outside the box. And I thought, oh, that's wonderful to have something that you can do that's no rules. You don't have any rules, you just do it.
Oh, wow.
So I just started doing it and realized that each page was a journey. And I didn't know how it was going to end up when I started doing the pages. And that's what I've enjoyed the most about doing all of these art journals is that it's a journey each time I do a page.
Hmm. Wow,
and I never know how it's going to end up.
That is so cool. It just takes you wherever it takes you, and
it
you're letting
does.
It take you there. That's kind of how life is if you let it, right? You just got to kind of float along sometimes and
that's right.
go along with that. All right, great. So I can't wait. That's you know, I didn't know about that fact when you, I knew you liked dolls, but what a great way to still be able to indulge in your passion with the dolls without actually having to buy the dolls.
Right.
You can just get pictures of them, and like you said, you get just as much enjoyment out of that. So all right, let's grab another one here.
So this one was actually a photograph journal that
a photograph album
that I had years and like probably 30 years ago. As a matter of fact, I had gotten this in Germany years ago. That's how they had photograph albums, were fabric covered like this. So
were the pages plastic or paper?
They're paper. And
okay.
So then I just used it to.
And this one does this have a theme or it's just
no
random?
No theme at all. It's
okay.
Just totally random.
Random.
Totally.
So you don't have to have a theme.
No, that's the fun of doing the journals, is that you don't have to have a theme. If you want a theme, and I encourage people who maybe don't know how to start doing something, if they have a passion about something or something that they really love, flowers or dolls or anything at all, just maybe start focusing on that to do their journals. And then it's amazing how you just evolve into doing something and you learn a lot about yourself, about what you really like.
Huh. All right, cool. All right, so that one's outside the box. And now this one's a little bit bigger. So this is a notebook.
It's just a three-ring binder. And they're just pages. And then I've used page protectors for each of them. And once again, there's no theme. Like some of the pages have a theme.
Yeah.
I've done, some of the pages have maybe Christmas or fashion. Or I've learned about myself doing these journals.
Mm-hmm.
Lori, that I really am fascinated by shoes and funky shoes. And a lot of my pages have like crazy looking shoes on them, and I never knew that until I started doing that, and they just had reappeared. And I like using words on the pages too, just words or things that inspire me in terms of a word, or maybe sometimes there'll be a word in the journal that doesn't mean anything, but I like the font style.
Oh, right.
So it's all thinking outside the box, and just whatever inspires you.
So
or inspires me goes into onto the page.
So when you're putting these together, and we're going to talk more in detail about the process, but I did want to ask about that. So when you're putting these together, you're flipping through magazines, and you're just like, oh, that looks great, I cut it out. That looks cool, I like that font, cut it out. So you're not really thinking too hard about this. You're just like grabbing whatever grabs your attention, and you just cut that out and put it in your pile.
Exactly. As a matter of fact, I'm really not thinking at all. I'm just being inspired by what I see in the magazines.
Wow.
And that's what goes onto the page.
Wow.
And I'm amazed sometimes at what inspires me, actually. I love old vintage things. Like these are from a Victorian catalog. So that's what ended up going on those pages. So these are kind of themes on these two pages. It's kind of the old vintage theme.
So sometimes you just use the pictures you cut out of the magazines, and sometimes you write little poems or sayings or quotes or words, and sometimes you cut the words out of the magazine.
Yes. And sometimes I'll use a photograph of, that one happens to be of myself, or of people, and it just...
Whatever.
There's no rules, and that's what I love about it, because there's so little in this life we can do that doesn't have rules attached to it. And this type of art journaling, there are no rules.
Wow. Okay, so I did have a question that just left my mind, but I'll think of it. Now let's. I mean, I could look at these. I'm gonna be looking at them again, but I just want to grab the. I think there's two more here that I just want to show.
That's the one that you had.
This is the one that I have seen, and so Cheryl puts a little ribbon around some of them, or some rubber bands, or something. Now. As you can see, the book, this was a book, right? Any kind of a,
right.
And when you glue the things in it, the book gets really fat. So it's hard to keep it closed. So that's why you have ribbons and rubber bands to kind of hold them together. Now, I have heard people also tear out every other page before they start and then the book gets skinnier, and then when you add the stuff, it doesn't get as fat. But you don't have to, it doesn't matter.
That's actually what I've done to these two that are in progress now, so that I can actually have a flat. And someone had told me that also, because I thought, oh my gosh, my book, it's getting so thick, it doesn't stand up. So this one, when I first had done it, I actually just had it standing like that on the coffee table, and it fanned out nicely. But I like the option of having a book be flat also.
Right, okay. All right, so that's a good trick for people to do. So this one was also random, and I know what I wanted to ask you. So when you cut, when you're cutting, so do you cut and then make a page, cut more, make a page, cut more? So what's your process?
There's really not a process even that I use. Sometimes I'll just tear a bunch of things out of magazines and I'll have a stack and I'll just start going through them and cutting out. And other times I'll tear things out and I'll have them cut out and I'll try to organize them a little bit into faces or shoes or whatever and then do it that way. But I find it's more rewarding and fun to just randomly do it and randomly see how a page is going to end up. Like this particular page is stamps that this gentleman gave me, the father of a dear friend of mine, gave me these stamps from a stamp collection, and I didn't know what to do with them, so I thought, into the journal they'll go.
And there they are.
They have a home. So there they are. So,
oh my gosh, it's just incredible. Like here, so here's a newspaper article. Is there a Santa Claus?
Yes, Virginia. Is there a Santa Claus? And yes, Virginia, there is, which is a very famous Christmas story from years ago. And when I was a little girl, I remember my dad telling me about this story, because I would always ask, is there a Santa Claus? And yes, there is. And then he would introduce this little newspaper article to me. So it was just a wonderful childhood memory that ends up also having a home on one of the journal pages.
Oh, wow. Boy. And so then you kind of ended up with some Christmas things around it. But, you know, again, it doesn't have to be that way.
It can be just whatever.
It's
thinking outside the box. That's what I loved about this first one, was the actual name of the journal was outside the box. And I thought, oh, that's kind of an interesting way to look at something.
So how long have you been doing these? About
2 years.
2 years.
I started 2 years ago. Mm. And this was the first one that I had done. Okay. And then I just realized how relaxing it is and how much fun it is to do it. Mm. And when I first started doing them, I was just doing them because I enjoyed doing them, and I happened to be at a friend's house, and her sister was there, who's an artist also, and happened to be, and I was showing my friend the book because she likes dolls as well, and her sister looked at it and was really fascinated by it, so I thought, oh, maybe these are meant to be shared with other people. Oh. At first I thought, who's going to be interested in? And I realized that the fun of doing the journals is then sharing them with others. And I like to put at the last page or somewhere in my journal thanking people for looking at my journal, because they're taking a little journey with me through these pages, and I love that. I love being able to share. And the journals are, they're personal, but they're not private. Mm. I mean, each person who does one of these journals, it's very personal to them, and that's what I love, sharing and seeing even other people's journals too. Mm.
Well, you know, you learn a lot about a person by looking at these, but also inspires others. So when I looked at these, I got so inspired to do my own. So in our next show next week, Cheryl's going to come back, and we're going to do a demonstration of how to make these journals, and I'll show you the one that I started. And you know, it's really an incredible process. So when I saw hers, I got so excited about it. It's something I've always wanted to do, so I decided to try my own. And we'll show you that next week if you tune in next week. So here's another one that this is done. Now I just want to stress here that just about every one of these is done on a different kind of a book. So we have an old scrapbook, and we have just a novel maybe from a thrift store. Then we've got this one. It looks like, is this a sketch pad?
This was actually a sketch pad. I had started doing sketches with this one, and then I just had started some. So some of the pages have the sketches. I was giving myself a little teaching myself how to draw art class. So I had several pages of sketches, but then I stopped doing that, and I thought, well, I've got this little sketch pad, and there's extra pages, so it can be a home for a journal as well. So that's how that evolved.
Well, what I love about it is on the cover, you've got the word artsy and artist at work. which I think is just so appropriate because of the fact that this started out as just a, not just, but as a sketchbook, and that you've got your sketches in here. It's so cool to mix in with the things you've cut out of magazines. So, by the way, I really love your drawings.
Thank you. It was fun. One of the things that inspired me to do these journals as well was Sarah Bond Breathnach several years ago had a book, I think it was called Simple Abundance, and mm-hmm. one of the pages, I have it I think in this journal, she talks about the Illustrated Discovery Journal, and it's amazing what you discover about yourself when you do these. Like I've discovered, I love color. I absolutely love color. Mm. So a lot of the pages are just vibrant with different colors, and you learn things that you maybe knew about yourself, but you didn't really know about yourself.
So it kind of brings it to your consciousness.
It does.
You know, because you do it, and then you might look at it later and go, wow, you know, like you said, oh my God, it's so colorful, or maybe it's not colorful, maybe it's always yellow, or maybe it's always red. So you didn't even realize that that's the colors that you're attracted to, and so that's very interesting. Now, what was the, tell me again,
Sarah Bond Breathnach was the author of the book, and it was called Simple Abundance.
Simple Abundance,
I think it's a guidebook of simple abundance.
Yeah, I've heard of it. I just wanted to make sure that everybody...
And she says just exactly what I do. She says what you do at night before you go to sleep, you can take a couple of magazines and just leaf through them. And she said, don't even be thinking about anything. Hmm. Just whatever on the page inspires you, rip it out and then put it into your discovery journal.
Do you have a favorite magazine that you like to look through and get pictures out of, or is it totally random again?
It's kind of random, but I do like the Oprah magazine, and I love the style magazines, like Vogue and InStyle, and I'm not that way personally myself, but I'm intrigued by it, and seeing like fashion and hairstyles, and I love that, and facial expressions.
Oh, wow. So you just, now you said that the office that you work at, chiropractor's office, how convenient is that? Because how many times you go in your doctor's office and they always have stacks of magazines. So that's really, then eventually they just dump them. So how convenient that is. You have a nice constant supply of variety of magazines to go through.
And catalogs also, different catalogs. Yeah. Like there's different, I have a pretend fantasy closet that I'm going to do one journal, and it will have a theme, and it'll be like my closet of what I wish could be in my closet, clothes and shoes and hats and purses and accessories.
Wow.
So that'll be my wardrobe journal.
Oh, wow.
That one will have a theme, but it'll still be thinking outside the box because there'll be things in that journal that I would never in a bajillion years wear.
Right.
That I like, so.
Well, it's all about just, you know, imagination
it
and
is.
Fantasy and, you know,
it's,
I also think that it could be useful for, you know, kind of, I mean, do you find it to be therapeutic for yourself?
It's very therapeutic and very relaxing.
Because I would imagine, like for myself, if I, you know, let's say I wanted to go on a trip around the world, again, I could just get some travel catalogs and do my trip around the world in my art journal instead of, I mean, sure, I'd still have to go on one, but I don't know if I ever will be able to. And also, you know, for me, sometimes if I get, you know, have a bad day, you know, two things could happen. Because when I was working on in my studio, I was having a bad day, and I just started looking through magazines, and I cut out every positive word that I could find, and every smiling face that I could find.
Oh, that's great.
And by the end of the 2 hours, I spent 2 hours on it, and I was like feeling like a new person. I felt so much better, because how could you not feel better when you've got all these positive things staring back at you? You know,
exactly.
People smiling and words that make you happy and. So that's just really, that's really nice. That's one of the things I noticed about the journal that I looked through was it was just so uplifting and positive and happy and joyful. And, you know, I mean, we don't always feel that way all the time, but...
No,
but
it brings you to that place,
yes.
And it's amazing. I will sometimes sit and do this journaling, and I'm amazed at the hours that go by. I mean, hours and hours, because you just become so involved in the journey of the journaling, and it's wonderful.
Well, you know that you're in the zone.
Yes.
If the time just flies by and you don't even realize it.
Right.
So you're onto something there. So if you at home want to try these, you just need a magazine, some glue stick, and an old book. And that's pretty much, and a pair of scissors.
And that's it.
That's it.
That is.
So I want to look at this. I want to go back now, and which one was the faces? This one?
Faces is this one.
All right. I just want to open this up a little bit more and talk. So I want to talk a little bit about what, now tell me again, you started doing Facebook, and then you decided to do...
And I just like the word Facebook. It's like, oh, Facebook. Ah. I think maybe it would be fun to do a journal of faces.
A Facebook. Right. And where do you get your quotes from, the ones that you...
Everywhere. I get some of them online. I have quote books. Oh. I've loved quotes forever, and I just love inspirational quotations.
So. And I've noticed that, and we're going to talk more about the process at the next week, but I noticed around the edges you put like little borders, little dots.
It's kind of like little stitching around the edges.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's amazing how much it really finishes the page off. I mean, it's just a little detail,
it
makes a big difference. It kind of, it's almost like putting a frame around a picture. You mm-hmm. know, it really makes it just come together. So I think this is just Facebook. I love that title.
It's just so fun. It's so fun.
So you can see on this one, especially on this page, there's the book. You can still see the words mm-hmm. behind the pictures that were here in the book. And so you don't have to. You know, some people I know say you should paint the page with gesso to seal it first. And that takes a long time, or with some matte medium or some kind of a medium so that it's easier to work with. But obviously, you don't have to do that. You can just stick it right on there, and who cares if the words show through? It's actually kind of interesting.
I kind of like the words showing through. Like, on most of the pages, I think the words aren't showing through, but on the ones that the words are showing through, I thought, I kind of like that look. And interestingly enough, in some of the books that I've done, some of the words that come through are words that are appropriate to the actual page.
But not intentionally.
No, not intentionally at all, which is, I mean, it's like, wow, there's another spirit or something doing this journal, and it's like amazing how that happens.
Wow.
And it's fun then to look at it and see.
Yeah, see how that worked. So did you do any research when you first started these regarding how to do them, or did you just...
No, not at all, not at all. I just liked cutting and pasting, and I just like happy things, or things, I like to do things that make me smile, because I think if something makes me smile, it's probably going to make others smile as well.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how all of the journals evolved, was, and some of them are just downright like silly that's in them, and just, it's just so fun. It's just, it's fun to do.
Okay, so let's see, which one, I want to show a little bit more of these. Yeah, the dolls. All right, well, first, before we even do that, because we have about, I don't know, 5 or 7 minutes left. So I want to show the audience at home that, so this is one that's not even started yet.
I haven't
started. So where did you get this book?
I got that at the Recycle bookstore just behind your studio.
On the Alameda in San Jose, the Recycle bookstore. And this is a book that is about Roman mythology.
And I loved it because a lot of the pictures in the book, I'm going to just use it as part of the journal. Mm. And I'll just collage around the pictures. I just love the...
So this book cost $1, right?
$1.99. And it's a beautiful book. It's just...
So in this case, you're just going to maybe save some of the pictures and collage around them.
And
this is a nice big, you have a lot of surface area. You can even use this to write whatever in here. All right, so that's how you start. You got this book that just was inspiring from the bookstore. And which one of these has just been started?
Both of these have just been started. Now these books, both of them, this one has kind of an interesting story. As you can see all around here, there's all of this coloring because I spilled coffee on it.
Okay, so I don't know if Jason can get that, but you spilled coffee on it, so you colored.
So it was stained. So I colored over
the edges.
It just to cover up my... So this one I have torn pages out in between so that it will lay flat.
I see. So you've got it about halfway done.
Right.
And it's pretty flat. So that seems to have worked. So you tore out every other page.
And even on this one, even there were lots of pictures actually in the book itself, and mm-hmm. I like the photographs. So these are also going to be part of the pages too. I'm just going to keep the photograph as is and then put maybe a little something over it, words or another little picture over
okay, cool.
the photograph that's there.
All right, so this one's just been about halfway done. So you can see a work in progress.
Sometimes what I do too, Lori, which is interesting, is I get kind of bored doing like page after page after page, so I'll skip to the back and do a couple of pages in the back. Or I'll do a couple of pages in the middle, just to not be have it be so
methodical.
Tedious.
Uh-huh.
And so that's what I've done with this one, is I thought, I'm tired of doing pages in the front, so I'll just go to the back and start working from the back and do.
Well, sometimes I read magazines from the back, just for that same reason, just to see, you know, sometimes there's more interesting things in the back of the magazine than the front. And I see you've decorated, put a little piece of lace on the front of here, so you're not limited to just magazine things. You could put anything on these.
Anything.
There's no rules.
The only limit is your own imagination.
And this is another one that just is started, so as you can see. Now, we only have a couple minutes left, so I just want to go through the process, which, again, we're going to go in more detail next week. But so you start with a book. That's the first thing you do is you have a book. And then you can tear the pages, every other page out if you want to. What do you do next?
Then next, I just start looking through magazines. Or I actually have things that I have torn out of magazines, and I have them in like a folder or in a little box, mm-hmm. and then just start doing it.
Well, so you need, you just take the glue stick, and you just might take, like, for example, let's get a page that has more things on it. All right, here we go. It's kind of like scrapbooking, right?
It's definitely
like scrapbooking, but a lot easier, so now you're going to do this page. So you just kind of grabbed a few pictures that you like that kind of made sense.
This page actually does have a little bit of a theme. I love the television program Rosemary and Thyme. It's on PBS station. And I went online and I got these pictures that I liked. So this is basically gardening and
then you lay out, lay them on the page first?
Sometimes I do, and sometimes I just start pasting them on. It just depends on what mood I'm in.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes I will lay them on to give like a little bit of a direction to go in, but most of the time I just start pasting.
All right.
And that's where you get more of a collage effect too later on, is if you have things overlapping each other or fitting into each other.
Right, okay. And I noticed also that we have like 1 minute left, so real quickly, this has colored pencil behind it.
It's just color, or it can be crayons.
Anything.
That's all I did was color.
Wow. All right, well, next week we're going to go into more detail about how to do the journal, so I hope you'll join us for that. And this is just such an interesting technique. I think it's very inspirational. And Cheryl, I really want to thank you for joining me today. It was a pleasure having you on and listening to your... You're so passionate about these. It's so great to hear your story about how you did it. So thank you for joining me. And we'll see you next week. And so for everybody else, thank you for joining us today. And I hope you'll give it a shot at your journals. And of course, shoot me an email if you do one. I'd love to hear your story. LoriKreinStudios.com. And we'll see you next week. I hope you'll join us then. And I hope you have a creative day. Bye-bye.